Welcome back. There's nothing like walking through a giant three-dimensional inflatable colon to start your morning, right? But it's actually a helpful way to learn about colorectal health to get ready for the Undy Run and Walk, which is taking place this weekend. We have Cleveland Clinic doctor. This is Dr. James Church. And we also have Ann Ritchie, who is actually a colon cancer patient that is with us this morning. And we're going to kind of talk about, we talk about this every year, and it's so important to raise awareness about colon cancer. So I'm going to start with you as we kind of walk through. Where can people walk through this?
This is going to be at the Undy Run this Saturday down on the east bank of the flats.
Okay, so Dr. Church, show me, we're talking normal colon tissue, so things to look for with these tests. And I think some of the biggest changes is the age that people are now getting tested.
But the important thing about colorectal cancer is that it's the one major cancer we can prevent.
Okay.
Because all cancers arise in a benign polyp, and we have on the wall of this colon some benign polyps over here. About 1 in 100 of these benign polyps are going to turn into a malignant cancer.
Okay.
So by taking the polyps off, we can prevent the cancer.
And it used to be age 50 you started to get tested. Now it's moved up 5 years?
It's moving because we're becoming aware that young people are getting cancer at an increasing rate.
And why is that?
Nobody knows. In general, colorectal cancer is more common the older you are.
Yeah.
So it's most common in the 70s and 80s year old age groups. But now the young people are getting it much more often, and it's a concern.
And so how often should you get tested? Once you start at 45, is this every couple years, every 5 years?
It depends on your risk. So
okay.
You can look at your family history and you can see whether you have symptoms or not. If you have no family history and no symptoms, you're at average risk. And so if you're clear with a colonoscopy, you have 10 years to the next one.
Now talk about some of the new screening test options. One of them is stool-based, is that correct?
Stool-based will diagnose cancer, but it won't prevent cancer.
Okay.
The only test that prevents a cancer is colonoscopy, because then you can take off those benign polyps before they have a chance to do you harm.
The other choice is a visual exam.
That's what the colonoscopy is.
Okay. Yes. So there's a couple different tests that, again, you can start at age 45. So I want to bring in Ann, who's a colon cancer patient. You were diagnosed with stage 3 colon cancer.
Mm-hmm.
This was in 2016.
Right.
So tell us how that happened.
I had just finished an all-heart CrossFit competition.
Uh-huh.
Thought I tweaked my back. 4 days later, I ended up in the ER and found out not only did I have colon cancer, but it also had abscessed and perforated my colon. So I had a major surgery where they removed my right colon, my right kidney, had an ostomy, did 12 rounds of chemotherapy, was told I had the all clear, and then this time last year, we found it had moved into my liver, and it was inoperable. So at that point, I went for a second opinion at the Cleveland Clinic.
And you were given 6 months to live.
I was given 6 months to live. And my wonderful team with Dr. Karana, he was very aggressive with my treatment. I did 7 rounds of chemo. Dr. Pantini did my liver surgery that I had been told was inoperable. I did 5 more rounds of chemotherapy. And 2 weeks ago, I am no evidence of disease.
Praise God.
Yes.
That's amazing.
And I'm back at CrossFit.
Yes.
My faith has brought me through, and my family and my support system. And I really want people to understand, even if you do get the diagnosis of cancer, it will be life-changing, but you can still have a wonderful life.
Yeah. And there's the National Undy Run Walk that you have a team, so you can actually support. You can go online. All the information will be on our website. So you show up in your underwear.
Well, they'll give you boxer shorts.
How does that work?
You will get a pair of boxer shorts when you get here. But, you know, go team butts and guts. That's my team.
And again, doctor, where will that be and what time?
It's at 1055 River Road in the flats on the east bank. The race starts at 9 o'clock, but get there at 7:30. That's when registration starts.
Okay. Dr. Church, thank you for being here. Thank you for the education. We, of course, are still praying for you.
Thank you so much.
So thank you, and good luck on Saturday with the big run and walk. We do want to mention Darcy Egan. She was actually a local teacher and a former friend of the show. She actually passed away with battling colon cancer, we're hearing just this month. She always loves sharing her message. I'm going to show you a couple of pictures here on your screen. She was always sharing messages of early awareness, and no doubt her segments on our show help raise awareness for others. So, of course, we are praying for Darcy Egan's family and, of course, for you too, Anne. We'll be right back.